Hi.
Hello. Our topic for the discussion today is all about finding the domain and range of a function. So in finding the domain, we are going to solve the equation for y in terms of x. There are three things to remember. Roman numeral number one, if y is a polynomial, the domain is the set of all real numbers. Roman numeral number two, if y is a rational expression and contains an expression d of x in the denominator, the domain is the set of real numbers except those values of x that make d of x equal to 0. And lastly, if y contains a radical expression n root of r of x, where n is an even natural number, the domain is the set of real numbers that make r of x greater than or equal to 0. It will be the same as finding the range. But this time, we are going to solve the equation for x in terms of y. Let us make it simple. So, if we have fraction or rational expression, we are going to avoid getting a denominator which is equal to 0. Again, if we have fraction or rational expression, we are going to avoid getting a denominator which is equal to 0. Why? Because that is undefined. And then, if we have a radical expression, we are going to avoid a negative value inside the radical. Again, if we have a radical expression, we are going to avoid getting a negative value inside the radical sign. Let us try to answer the examples. We are asked to determine the domain and range of each of the following function. Number one, 3x minus 4 minus y is equal to 4. We are going to solve y in terms of x to find the domain. Let us simplify the equation. We will be having negative y is equal to 4 minus 3x. Okay, remove the negative. So we will be having y is equal to negative 4 plus 3x. As you can see in our equation, we don't have a radical or a rational expression. In that case, we don't have a restriction for the domain. So our domain here will be, the domain will be x such that x are elements of all real numbers. Let us solve for the range. From the equation 3x minus y is equal to 4, we are going to solve for x in terms of y. So let us manipulate the equation. We will be having 3x is equal to 4 plus y. Then divided by both sides by 3, we have x is equal to 4 plus y over 3. As you can see in our equation, we have a rational expression, but the variable is in the numerator. So there will be no instances that we will be having a denominator which is equal to 0. With our domain, our range here will be y such that y are elements of all real number because there will be no restriction. Problem number 2. Y is equal to x squared minus 4. Let us solve the domain. So we are going to solve y in terms of x. No need to manipulate the equation because that is already in that form. So we don't have a radical. We don't have a rational. So we don't have a restriction. Our domain here will be x such that x is an element of all real numbers. Okay? Let's solve for the range, or we are going to solve x in terms of y. Let us manipulate the equation. We will be having y plus 4 is equal to x squared. We need to remove the squared. How? Square root the both sides. Okay? So we will be having square root of y plus 4 is equal to x. Or we can rewrite it as x is equal to square root of y plus 4. This time around, we have a radical. So there will be a restriction. Again, what is the restriction for a radical? Avoid negative value. Based from our definition, x should be greater than or equal to 0. So let us how are we going to do that? Get the equation inside the radical. This is the equation, y plus 4. Y plus 4. Based from our definition, it should be greater than or equal to 0. So to solve for the value of y, just transpose the 4. It will give us y is greater than or equal to negative 4. So this will be our value of range. Y should be greater than or equal to negative 4. So range is equal to y such that y is greater than or equal to negative 4. Okay? Problem number 3. Y is equal to square root of 5 minus 2x. We are going to solve y in terms of x to solve for the values of domain. So we have a radical here. What is the restriction for a radical? The value inside the radical should be greater than or equal to 0. What is that? That is 5 minus 2x. So we have 5 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 0. We are going to solve for the value of x coming from this equation. Transpose 5. It will give us negative 2x is greater than or equal to negative 5. Divide both sides by negative 2. So based from the rules of inequalities, if we are going to multiply or divide inequalities by negative sign, we are going to change the inequalities. So if that is greater than, it will become less than. If that is less than, it will become greater than. So in our example, it will become less than. X is less than or equal to 5 over 2. So this will be the value of our domain. So the domain here will be x such that x is less than or equal to 5 over 2. Clear? Next, we are going to solve for the range. Solve for x in terms of y. Y is equal to square root of 5 minus 2x. So the first manipulation that we are going to do is to square both sides. We will be having y squared is equal to 5 minus 2x. We squared both sides to remove the radical sign. Then, transpose 5. We will be having y squared minus 5 is equal to negative 2x. Let us make x as positive. So multiply them by negative. It will give us negative y squared plus 5 is equal to 2x. Then, divide both sides by 2. So 2 here is cancelled. X will be equal to negative y squared plus 5 over 2. We have a rational expression here, but the variable is in the numerator. So based from the rules in ration, we will try to avoid getting a denominator which is equal to 0. But in this example, the variable is in the numerator, so there will be no instances that we will be having a denominator which is equal to 0, meaning our range will be y such that y is an element of all real numbers. Okay? So thank you. That's all for today. Have a nice day.